I think we've touched briefly on the three broad themes that we've been working on over the last few years. One of them is really finding methods to reach out to patients and include them in our research. We've done that really at every level, from middle schools through to direct-to-consumer approaches in a variety of different settings. And we're refining that constantly as we go through the research period in One Brave Idea. The other two areas that we have been really focused on are empowering patients to take charge of their own care. And one of the things that we found was that in many instances, families who had risk were not really able to communicate that risk effectively to their providers, that there was a difficulty, partly because people are in different health systems, they're in different insurance plans, they're at different age groups. How did we begin to build a set of tools that would empower an individual who had a disorder to communicate the risk of that disorder to his relatives, to other family members, and have them then take that information in a way that could be used by their own providers locally without us having to undertake a massive research effort, actually making it part of what just was the natural occurrence after a diagnosis like this. The evidence base is very strong for that. And if we could implement that technology, i.e. genetics, in a rigorous way, the actual tools for genetics have been stable for about a decade, yet only about 5% of those with genetic risk for heart disease actually ever get tested for it. If we could find a way to empower patients to change that risk equation, we could then do that iteratively for new technologies as they emerged and so on.